Good morning students, today we are discuss about changes around us. Okay, so now you see that changes take place around us all the time. A change refers to an alternation in physical properties or alternation in the composition of the matter. Okay, wow. So all the change refers to an alternation in the physical properties or alteration in composition of matter. For example, ice melt on eating. Okay, further you are eating means the liquid change to that evaporation, right? For example, ice melting on eating. So ice melting after that what is changing means liquid. Okay, the solid change to the liquid. Further you are eating means that liquid evaporate. Okay, it change from a liquid to gas. Here there is a change in the physical state of the substance. Let us look at another change, that is when object is made of the iron or exposed to moist condition, a reddish brown new substance called rust forms on the surface of this object. Okay, the iron rusting, the iron changed to the rust portion. Okay, in this instance of rusting there is change in composition. This is a change in composition of the substance. Thus the change involves an alternation in the properties such as color, texture and state of substance, since there is formation of new substance also, right? Let us see, go for another set of example. Heat a cup of water and vapor. The water upon heating becomes just hotter and hotter, and at some points will come water vapor. Some points will become water vapor. It is remaining water at all times, that is the water remains the same only. It is volume change and hence it is called as physical changes. So whereas in case of the burning of the paper changes to carbon dioxide and other substances. Now we can get back the paper after burning. Cannot get, okay. After the burning paper, we cannot get again, right? As there is change in the chemical nature. So it is called as chemical change, okay. So now you see that if some of the example effects. You see that the solid, liquid and gas, right? Solid, all the solid or liquid, gas, all the materials having packed in the molecules, some small particles, right? So now you see that solid. You see that picture, all the molecules is here closely packed, right? In which particles are very close together. Particles are arranged in a fixed regular pattern. Particles can vibrate about their fixed position only, right? So next you see that liquid. So this molecules are not a compressed, it's a liberate only. You see that in which the particles are close together. Particles are not arranged in a fixed regular pattern. Particles are able to slide past one another, right? Next you see that, so here more, it is this particles are more, each one having to more gap, right? The particles are far apart from each other. The particles are not arranged in the fixed regular pattern. Particles move freely over long distance, right? So next you see that effect of heat on solid, liquid and gas. Upon heating, particle arrangement within the state of the matter get disturbed. The disturbance in the disturbance is seen either as expansion or contraction. When heated or cooled, the object may expand or contract. Heat means expanded, cooled means contract. But the mass remaining the same. That is the number of particles that was inside object does not undergo any change. The molecule undergo. The particles having more molecules, that molecules not a change, right? Only the arrangement of the particle changes. So that place is wherever place that molecules, that place only changed. Okay. When a glass of water is heated, its volume increases, and if a glass of water is cooled, its volume decreases. Okay. Such changes where there is change in volume but mass remaining the same are called physical changes, and they can be the pictorial depicted as following. You see the pictorial effect of each again may result in the melting, boiling, freezing and condensation. May result in evaporation for contraction. So this one, this brings about change in state during which volume changes, mass is contracted. Okay. So now you see that there are other possibilities that can occur upon heating the solids, liquids and gases. The possible changes are due to melting, boiling, freezing and condensation, during which there is change in the physical state of the particles of the matter. Let us discuss about them in the detail, short while. Okay, so now you see first one is a physical changes, right? You see that the physical changes are change in which only the physical properties of a substance undergo a change, and there is no change in its chemical composition. There is no new substance formed in a physical change. Physical properties include luster, metability and ductility and density, viscosity, solubility, mass, volume and so on. Any changes in three physical properties is referred to as the physical change. For example, when a rubber band is stretched, it elongates. However, when stretching is stopped, the rubber band comes back to its original state and shape. In the example, there is no new substance formed, but the rubber band remaining the same before and after elongation. Right. So some of the physical property characteristics of the physical change. First one, during a physical change, no new substance are formed. In a physical change, the chemical properties of a substance do not change. For example, when ice cube melt, water is formed. In this change, there is no new substance, but water is same both ice and water. The physical change is usually temporary and reversible in nature. For example, when water is heated, water vapors are formed. Once water vapor are cooled, again the water can be obtained again. Okay, so next you see, in the physical change, the chemical properties of substance do not change. For example, when a piece of gold is melted, in chemical composition remaining the same in the solid form and also in the liquid forms. Physical change, the physical properties such as color, shape and size of the substance may undergo the change. For example, cutting of the vegetables and inflating a balloon are some example of the physical changes in which size and shapes of a substance undergoes change. We know it is not. Thank you, children.